block of wood, a plane that I can raise and lower. I'm going to demonstrate the forces on a block that's stationary on a plane. If the plane is horizontal, there will be a gravitational force down on the block, pulling it down toward the center of the Earth, and a normal force perpendicular to this horizontal surface, pointing vertically upward. Those two, because the block is not moving, those two forces must have equal magnitudes in opposite directions. If we raise the plane up a little bit, put it at a certain angle, we introduce a third force. We've still got gravity pulling it straight down toward the center of the Earth. We still have the normal force, and in this case, well, as before, the normal force is perpendicular to the plane here. So it's not quite vertical now. It's often at an angle that's exactly 90 degrees from this direction. And we have one more force, which is stopping this block from sliding down the plane. It's the static friction force that stops it from sliding. If there were no friction, the block would slide down the plane. And that tells me that the friction force must be in the direction opposite the direction it would move if there were no friction. If we increase the slope, we get to the point where static friction is no longer capable of holding the block up the plane, and the block accelerates down the plane. And we can study that problem as well using kinetic friction instead of static friction. That's blocks and planes.